Recently, Indian Railway have announced their 100 days action plan. While we are welcoming some of the aspects of 100 days action plan by Indian Railways, we are very much concerned about two aspects. One is making the corporation of all the production units, and another one is private train operators entering into the operation of trains. There are 7 production units available in Indian Railways, which are started from right from the year 1950, the oldest one, CLW at Bengal, and the newest one is MCF Rae Bareli in the year 2011. All these production units are not only termed to be as only as factories, they are the mini town. They are having the infrastructure not only for manufacturing of rolling stocks required for Indian Railways, they are having their colonies, schools, colleges, other establishments like hospitals, post office, bank, and well, they can be termed it as mini town on their own. All this infrastructure has been created over many decades. These 7 production units have 35 square kilometer of land in their command. To compare, we can say Tirupati town is having the area of 29 square kilometer. By corporating these 7 production units, we fear that it will be a first step towards the privatization of all this production of rolling stocks. Not only that, the government says that it is a policy of Make in India. Prime Minister is very much eager to implement the policy of Make in India in Indian Railways, especially in manufacturing of production units, manufacturing of coaches and other rolling stocks. But these production units, by making them as corporation, cannot manufacture a world standard coaches as expected by our Honorable Prime Minister. Where China has attained a world standard in manufacturing of high speed trains recently. They have reached that standard not only by inviting MNCs into their country. First, they have developed their skill set. China is having many universities and colleges and institutions who teach about railways, who do research on railways, and after 10 years the result has come out very well in China for running of high speed trains, manufacturing and running of high speed trains. So India has to first develop its skill set to manufacture the world class high speed trains, rather than proposing it for corporatization of existing production units. If the existing production units are corporatized, the cost of rolling stock, the cost of coach will immediately go up by at least by 50%. A corporation has to pay a corporate tax of 30% to the government, and they have to fix at least a minimum profit. So a coach which cost 1 crore now will be costing 1.5 crore if it is made as corporation. So this cost will be lying on the levied on the head of general public who has to buy the ticket for their travel. Not only this, as I told, the production units as a factory, as a colony, as other establishment, they are the living example, they are representing the presence of government of India in all the 7 places, and they have developed lot of surrounding areas, surrounding industries, other supplementary industries has been depending on not only this 50,000 employees employed in these 7 production units. Apart from this, every production unit is getting the material from other industries, major or small, many small scale industries and micro level industries, they are all supplying. Every production unit at least support 30 to 40,000 employees other than the railway employees. So all their bread and butter will be a big question if they are being privatized or corporatized. So all the unions of 7 production units, we are very, very much vehemently opposing the move by Railway Board, Railway Ministry to convert the 7 production units into a corporation. One of the important thing is the land in the command of all these production units. For example, ICF, Integral Coach Factory, Chennai, which is situated in the middle of Annanagar, Ayanavaram and Villivakkam, which are having a very high real estate value. ICF is having 511 acres in its command. If it has been in the name of privatization and disinvestment, if it has gone into the hand of private people, they will be eyeing on the real estate value of this high value land, and they will not be contributing for any production activities of railways. The another important thing is government is looking for private partnership in the manufacturing sector of rolling stock. As on today, there is no such entrepreneur available in India. If it is made as public-private participation, naturally all these production units will end up in the hands of multinationals, and we will be at the Indian Railways will be at the mercy of MNCs. We as government employee, we have a bitter experience of this corporatization on previous occasions. For example, BSNL, MTNL and BSNL. So from the previous experience, we find that the corporatization is only to scale down the activity of government. Likewise, we fear that the production units of Indian Railway will be scaled down and all the activity will be handed over to private parties. You